What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Siouxsie and the Banshees. Once again, shout out to Nicola for making this available. We're continuing through their album Kaleidoscope, 1980, and the next tune is called Desert Kisses. It's a really interesting juxtaposition, a desert, something that is barren, no moisture, no life, or at least the bare minimum that might be possible. And ultimately, kisses is something that is warm, inviting. Kisses can be wet, certainly, but it feels like a juxtaposition that is not going to be just physical. It feels like there might be some psychology at play here. But yeah, it's a really interesting phrase. If it's some, cultural phrase that's used in a particular way, I'm unfamiliar with it. It feels like it could be an idiom, though. It feels like the check's in the mail, or the grass is greener on the other side. It's a desert kiss. It feels, a Pyrrhic victory. It feels like something that could be a pop culture phrase that I'm just not familiar with. But yeah, if it isn't that, I'm really curious about the themes or the psychology behind it. So let's find out. This is Siouxsie and the Banshees. The tune is Desert Kisses, and it's from the 1980 album Kaleidoscope. Feel this twisted, warped, psychedelic.
Sinking down without a sound. That's just incredible. I don't know. I've begun in the last, a couple months doing reactions to this group, usually on the same night as the Cocteau Twins. And again, I don't know if people like hear some of these similarities, but I think I've begun to do that because the way their songs are darkly compelling, they sound very... what's the right word? Basically, they sound wicked at the same time that they sound a bit bright and interesting. Like, it's a really complicated atmosphere. And even though, you know, they're not identical, again, I don't think it's a coincidence that I've begun reacting to both groups on the same night. But again, it felt psychedelic, it felt warped, it felt like there was a malaise over the tune. And then we're talking about sinking into the ground on the moving ground, and there's no one around, you know, no one to help, no one to observe what's, you know, no one to be witness to something like this. And, you know, seemingly it was a bit cheeky with the, you know, the play on the idea, if a tree falls over in the forest, is, you know, does it make a sound if there's no one there to hear it? You know, I have answers to that question, but we don't need to digress into a philosophical chinwag. Nevertheless, it seemed like they were playing off that concept a little bit, and I enjoyed that. So, yeah, darkly compelling tune, really enjoying this group. Once again, shout out to Nicola for making Siouxsie and the Banshees available, as well as Solo Siouxsie and Creatures. There's much more to come. Again, it's just hard to go through all these different deep dives with any degree of celerity these days, especially in the last week. Although I have finished my lecture, like, I got that ready to go, and, you know, I've talked to my mentor, and he says it's good, ready to go. So, I was able to shoot more videos in the last day or two than I thought I might be. But nevertheless, yeah, it's just, you know, I will try to keep going through both Siouxsie and the Banshees, Cocteau Twins, and everything else as rapidly as I can. But yeah, I thank everybody for their patience, is what I mean to say. Perhaps more concisely next time. In any case, let me know what you think of this. I'll see you. Peace.